Hello, I'm Dr. Karen with Embrace Life Ohm and MotherCore. And in today's short video, I'm going to talk about the proper dosing of red and infrared light. This is part of our continuing series on light and your health. And if you want information about what red and infrared light therapy is and what it can do for you, please watch our preceding video on red and infrared light therapy. As we covered in our previous video, there are four frequencies which are particularly bioactive in the body. These are 620 and 680, which are red light, and 780 and 830, which are infrared light. And frequencies near these frequencies are bioactive as well. Now, the studies have shown that you need a minimum amount of energy near these frequencies in order to have a therapeutic effect in the body. However, if you have too much energy near these frequencies, it will overstimulate the mitochondria, putting you into oxidative stress. Now, the studies have shown that to get the optimal amount of light in these frequencies, you want to get a light dose that is between 1 and 20 joules. Within this range, the optimal dose for near surface issues, such as skin, hand joints, thyroid, etc., is about 5 joules. The optimal dose for deeper problems, such as lower back pain or brain inflammation, is near 20 joules. If you have a significant problem that's deeper in the body, you can push it to 30 joules. However, as you push past 30 joules, you run the risk of doing damage to your skin. Now, joules is a measure of total energy, and total energy is the product of the irradiance, or the rate at which energy is entering your skin per second, times the total amount of time that you're under that irradiance. And the irradiance that we're worried about here is the irradiance that is near those targeted bioactive frequencies. Now, the best way to know your irradiance is to purchase an LED red and infrared light like this one from redlightman.com and to have the manufacturer tell you what the irradiance is at different distances. And redlightman.com provides you with a great chart giving you the irradiance and the distance, and also provides you with a great chart telling you the best joules to use for different conditions. You want to try to use an irradiance between 20 and 40 milliwatts per centimeter squared, because that mimics what you would naturally receive from the sun, and studies have shown that those irradiances are safe and good for your body. With this device, you get an irradiance of 20 milliwatts per centimeter squared at a distance of 50 centimeters. In order to get the 5 joules that are optimal for treating near surface conditions, you're going to want to get that 20 milliwatts per centimeter squared for 4 minutes. In order to treat a much deeper problem, you may want to increase your time to 16 minutes. But in all cases, try to keep your session length below 25 minutes, because as you go over 25 minutes and over 30 joules, you risk doing damage to your skin. Now, if you want to use a regular incandescent red light bulb, you're going to use this for a longer period of time because less of the light that is being produced is in the bioactive frequencies. So you're going to be receiving more energy into your body, but the energy at the less bioactive frequencies is not going to send you into oxidative stress so quickly. Now, I was able to find one published study on using a regular incandescent light. Unfortunately, this study was using skin cells in a petri dish rather than skin cells on people. But that study found that they used the light at 45 centimeters for a half hour to get optimal results. Now, the other issue with this study is that they were cooling the skin cells to keep them at a constant temperature. So if you're going to use it for a full 30 minutes, you might want to use a fan or squirt yourself with water in order to make sure that you're not overheating, as overheating can make the results less potent. Alternatively, I've seen other people say to use this light at that distance for about 20 minutes. Now, there's one excellent tip about doing red light therapy that I got from this book, Red Light Therapy, Miracle Medicine by Mark Sloan. And he recommends doing your therapy with your clothes off and lying down. There are two good reasons for this. One, if you're lying down doing the therapy, it helps you be a lot more relaxed. And I definitely found that I was able to relax a lot better doing the therapy lying down rather than standing up trying to get a particular body part in the light beam. The second thing he's saying that to have all your clothes off while you're lying down, because you may have a problem with a particular body part, but that body part may be talking to some other parts of your body. So he recommends getting the red light over your entire body for the therapy, with it focused on your body part of interest. The last important thing is how frequently you need to do your red and infrared light therapy sessions. Studies have been done with therapy frequency anywhere from 2 to 14 times per week. However, most people seem to get good results with 2 to 5 sessions done weekly. The studies have also shown that you need to do at least 2 to 3 weeks of therapy before seeing any real results. In particular, for brain healing, they actually sometimes do one session and then do nothing for 3 weeks and see those results 3 weeks later. But in general, you want to be doing regular sessions 2 to 5 times a week for several weeks and then see what happens. And usually by 5 weeks, you should definitely be getting some clear results. Thank you so much for watching today's show, and good luck with your red and infrared light therapy.